Hello!
How are we doing?
It's my badger. Now, we're entering Code Black.
I don't know what it means.
Double O gingers.
Yeah.
I mean, when Andrew showed me this beer, it made me think of special agents and secret organisation and stuff like that. Like Black Ops and stuff like that.
What was the amount of that American TV show that did a spy film?
The one with the
little kid or something.
I think I know what you mean, but what's that one that
he used to have gadgets in his backpack and that.
It's a bit of gadget.
Oh, in his backpack.
Oh. Anyway. This is Block IPA from Hardknott Brewery, 5.6%. We're not too keen on. We've not had too many bottles from Hardknott Brewery.
No,
we've had more on tap than anything else. Because Stuart, we go to some bars like the Sparrow in Bradford,
The
Grove in Huddersfield, and a few other bars, and each one get a good selection of good craft beer and real ales. Like building combination. Definitely a little bit of smokiness there. Don't smell. But yeah, I mean, when insulin is cold black, it's like cold yellow and such.
Who that one? It's like a sort of a chalkiness.
I mean, when the president would say code red, it'd be urgent. So I'm guessing code black is.
I'm going for this glass here.
I don't know what the theme is behind. Let's look. there's actually in the information, which I've put in the information about. We could tell you it's black IPA, and if we did, we'd be letting you into a great secret. But as you don't believe in black IPA, you can just pass over this beer and move on to a dark mild or after all, blah 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 blah. I know a lot of people don't say black IPA; they say black ale. Or they don't say black ale; they say swash beer, which is smoky
lager. Yet again, Hardknott breaks the downplay conceptions. Code Black makes the other less interesting. Beer pale is in a
significant. Just put it over there.
Was exploding.
Look at that angle.
I'm just noticing it.
It does use Amarillo, Centennial, Galaxy, Nelson Sauvin, Obstruding.
It says here, welcome to the dark side. Keep it secret, keep it safe. And do not let it fall into the wrong hands. As they
you definitely get some rust to that. A little bit of flour.
You're supposed to get citrus lemon aromas mingled with hints of gentle taste or bitter chocolate orange. Flavours are fine, assertive of bitter finish.
Try and get rid of that head.
It came quite. As soon as I poured it, boom.
Oh, there you go. Get a little smokiness there. I'm going to try to see that pour it up on my top. I think it's smokiness, you get a little bit of woody berries, you know, like the ones when you go to a forest.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit of smoking berries and you know, when you just like.
It's, you know what it smells like? As if you get go up to in the forest and sniff a tree.
Yeah. Sniff a tree. Go up to a forest and sniff a tree.
Sniff a tree and like you get that nice woody smoky smell.
Yeah, there's definitely a woody smoky smell there. At the edge.
Oh. Yeah, I mean.
Again, I'm getting like a forest berries and stuff like that. I'm trying to keep it.
Now, I'm smelling the glass. I'm sort of getting like a Black Forest ghetto almost.
Well, it's not as rich as a Black Forest ghetto, because a Black Forest ghetto has like frozen dark chocolate, dark berries and stuff. You're not getting that. You're getting a little
almost
bit.
You almost get the chocolate as well now.
Yeah.
The cocoa almost smell. There's a bit of a cocoa smell.
Yeah, there's definitely some roast in there as well.
Yeah.
But you're looking like it's almost like those like floor malts and stuff like that.
Very smooth tasting. You don't pick up that it's 5.6 and that it's very easy drinkable.
Yeah, you get the underlying little coffee aromas which you would normally get for dark beer.
Slight bitterness there.
Yeah. And actually, Andrew had a double espresso the other day.
Yeah.
And it has keys of that, really, because it has that striking, rich coffee, but then it snatches away just as you, and then bang, then you get the most.
Because I thought with that double espresso, because when we went to Sardinia, the coffee was sweeter.
Yeah.
But it was like bang, full of flavor, full of espresso flavor. Then it was just like bitter, bitter afterwards.
Well, this is actually got some bitter aftertaste, which you normally would get a bitter taste from an IPA.
Oh,
there you go again.
Very lively this beer, anyway.
But it's not dark. It's.
Consider the fact that
rubyish, like a trickle.
The best before day. That's the best before day. Is 2015, which was so. And when I bought it, was just before Christmas.
It's not. It's a slight off white head.
So what I'm trying to say is that you maybe. It's a bottle to age, you reckon?
Yeah, I mean, you purchased this at Booth's in Ilkley. What was the price?
I think it was like a couple of, less than £2. And it was, I thought, oh, bargain. I was like, oh, I'm going to go for that.
Yeah, because we haven't had that much Hardknott beers. But this is our second bottle tonight, and.
But you can.
It's a nice little beer.
There's a beer you can keep, you know what I mean, as well. So
final thoughts. Love the taste.
It's a bit long. It's, bitterness
it's,
there.
Yeah, it's got a lot of bitterness and a lot of roast and a tiny touch of chocolate. You know when you sprinkle chocolate on top of the coffee?
I'm almost getting it.
You definitely get that woody berry, like.
No, I'm getting now more of a sweet but bitter feel to it. It's quite tingly on the tongue.
Yeah. But this is probably the first time we've had the cold black in bottle and it's a real test beer. What about again? Yeah.
Yeah.
You?
Definitely. Maybe even age it, you know what I mean?
Check out Boost, check out Hardknott. You take care.
Goodbye.